Okay, we have been discussing the chapter number 7, triangle. Okay, the concept triangle is wide variety, but we are discussing a simple topic about the triangle, that is called the congruency. Clear? And in the term congruency, we have discussed about the SAS criteria, side angle side, and the second criteria that we have discussed is ASA, right? In these two, the first was the SAS, side angle side. This is not a theorem, this is an axiom. An axiom is that which does not need to prove to be true. Is that clear? This statement is taken for granted, means ready-madely we use them. They are called axiom, and this is the definition of axioms also. Okay, what is the definition of axiom? An axiom is that which does not need to prove to be true, and ready-madely it is accepted. Is that clear? Right. The theorem one we have proved, ASA theorem. However, this session 2021 in, the proof of theorem has been removed from your course content right now. But I am telling you how to prove this, because you must know this. Without knowing the reason how the ASA, our angle side angle, is working. Two triangles are there, two angles including sides of one triangle equals to two angle and including side of another triangle are equal, then both the triangles can superimpose each other. This superimposition is called congruency. This is called congruency. Is that clear? So another property we are going to discuss, this is called isosceles property of triangle. What is an isosceles property of triangle? Clear? And the trick of that, as we move ahead, right now, as we move go on, means we just move on further in the study, the results which we already have discussed in the chapter are to be further used as a ready-made result, as a true statement. Clear? So we are going to discuss today the isosceles property of triangle. Okay, so first you know the meaning of isosceles. I am drawing here a triangle. Is that clear? And the triangle is said to be here isosceles. However, the triangle is not isosceles, this is isosceles triangle. So what do you understand by that triangle isosceles? Here, a triangle I have drawn here. Clear? Name of the triangle is ABC. Obviously, this triangle is equal to this triangle. Right? Sorry, this side is equal to this side in that triangle. Clear? Right? You may say that given in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC. This is you have been given. Okay? And what is to prove? To prove the side opposite angle of this here, that the opposite angle to that also. Is that clear? The angle opposite to this side is this, and the angle opposite to this side is this. Clear? So we have to prove angle B is equal to angle C. This is to prove here. Clear? I'm repeating this statement here. In a triangle ABC, you have been given AB side is equal to AC side. You need to prove this angle is equal to this angle. It means sides are equal, then you have to prove angles are equal. How can you prove this? Simple. As we have been studying the mathematics, congruency of the triangle. So congruency of the triangle can be used here. Clear? Look this now. So for that, the two sides are here. Clear? In triangle ABC, this is what is to prove here? The statement of isosceles property. You may write down the statement here. Go on writing, please. In a triangle, if two sides are equal, then the angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Listen again. in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then the angles opposite to equal sides are equal. This we have to prove. Clear? How can we prove this, please? So you have been given here a triangle ABC. In that, both the sides are equal. Clear? The two sides are equal. We need to prove their angles is equal. So given in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC, and to prove angle B is equal to angle C. So for that we need to do construction here. There is another angle here. Okay. So we'll draw here angle bisector. Okay. Can we draw this one angle bisector? I'm telling this in a triangle. Suppose that the triangle is given here. For this angle, you can draw angle bisector. You can draw perpendicular bisector. Is that clear? Is that clear or not? You can draw perpendicular bisector, you can draw angle bisector, you can join the median also. Right now, three things and three geometry can be constructed here in a triangle from a vertex to opposite side. Clear? So we are drawing here. Obviously, so this angle is equal to this angle, 1 is equal to angle 2, as we have constructed. Clear? Can we construct this or not angle bisector? The method of constructing angle bisector, I am telling you. Suppose there is angle. Listen here. This is a method of constructing bisector of angle. Suppose there is an angle. We have to construct bisector of this. So take your rounders and keep this at here and make an acute angle. Take an arc making an acute angle. Is that clear? That this is. And for the taking the same arc, we need to cut it. Is that clear? So they are intersecting the point, join this point from the vertex. A line be drawn here. A line will come here. That will line divide the angle in two equal parts. Is that clear? Right? This is the method of dividing any angle into equal parts. Clear? So see that we have constructed here AD. Name of this is AD. So you may write down here this. Proof is to be started here. So for the proof, what we are doing here? Draw angle bisector. Go on writing this. Angle bisector of angle A. Draw angle bisector of angle A. Draw angle bisector of angle A. We have drawn angle bisector of angle A. Name of this is, that is what? What is the name of this side? That is AD. AD is the angle bisector. Is that clear? Now what you have to prove here? We have to prove angle B is equal to angle C. This angle B is. You may see on the figure, these angle B and AC are the angles of this triangle and this triangle. Clear? So you may, what typical pattern you are observing here? As we have studied already, the pattern of asa and sas. Is there any pattern you are observing? You may see it. This angle is equal to this already. Clear? This first pair of angle equal. And we have to prove this side, may see this one, is equal to this side. It is given. It is given. And this side is common in them. You may see. It's a side, angle, side. Side, angle, and side. What pattern we are observing? SAS. What pattern we are observing? SAS. So both the triangle we can prove them they are congruent. So here you will write, draw angle bisector of angle A such that is AD. Clear? And what further we can do? So you will write down here, in triangle ABD and triangle ADC. In triangle ABD and triangle ADC. ABD, ACD. This you can take here. ABD, then here you can take ACD. The two triangles we are talking about. Clear? So what? It's a AB. Clear? It's a AB is equal to what? It's AC. Tell me please why. Tell me why I have wrote this.
Why I have written this?
This is given. It's a given. You may see that in triangle. In triangle, two sides are equal, then the sides are equal. Clear? They are given. And you will see that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Tell me please why this is.
By construction.
You need to write down by construction. Okay? Here you will. By construction. You will write here by construction. Also, this AD side is equal to AD side. Tell me please why this is.
Common.
This AD, this AD side is also coming in ABD triangle and ADC also coming in ACD triangle. Right? This is called common. It's common. Is that clear? So what pattern we have? Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. ABD is congruent to what they have please sir? ABD is congruent to ACD. Clear? What congruency is working here? You will write here by side angle set. Are both congruent here? And if they are congruent, then therefore, what we can write here? Angle B is equal to angle C. The angle B and C are not to be written here. Why? Because angle B is in the triangle ABC. You need to write down here ABD triangle is equal to ACD triangle. Tell me please why?
By
CECT. By CECT. Clear? That is, these angles are therefore angle B is equal to angle C. These two angles are equal. Has proved here or not? We have found the equality of the two angles. Okay? These two angles are coming equal. These two angles are coming equal. These two angles are coming equal as a result of equality of these two sides. Clear? So we can speak this is the isosceles property. In a triangle, if two sides are equal, then their opposite angle will be equal. Can you speak the converse? What the converse is? If the two sides are equal, then opposite angles are equal. What is the converse of this? Yes? No, converse theorem. Converse of 7.2 theorem. Can I speak the converse of this theorem? Sides are equal, then angles are equal. Opposite? If angles are equal, then side will also be equal. You may check this. So what the statement here? You go on writing the statement. In two triangle, is like this. This angle given equal to this angle. Okay? Same statement will be here as. In a triangle, if two angles are equal, in a triangle, if two angles are equal, then the side opposite to equal angles will also be equal. This is the statement. Clear? Well, understood you what I said you to? In a triangle, if the two angles are equal, then the side opposite to equal angles are also equal. This we need to prove here. Clear? How can we prove this? Message? A, B, C. We are given B equal D. Same you will do here. We'll draw here a perpendicular. No, sorry. It's angle bisector. Same what I have done here is. The line will repeat it here. You go on writing the solution. Proof. You have to write down in triangle ABC, AB equal AC. To prove B angle is equal to C. Conversely, what do you write given? What's given here? Go on writing this. Given in triangle ABC. Similarly, same things to be written here. Given in triangle ABC, what? AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. Now, it's to prove here, angle B is equal to angle C. Angle B is equal to angle C. Have done? Angle B is equal to angle C. And what next is? What is to prove?
AB equals AC.
Yeah, AB is equal to AC. This is to prove. Start writing this. Proof. Begin from here. Draw angle bisector. So need to draw angle bisector. We have drawn angle bisector. Same construction we are doing that. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. And these angles are given already equal. You may see that. It's an angle or it's a side. You may see this angle side. So have you studied the angle side? No, you have not studied the angle side. We have studied side angle. But angle side not. So another theorem we are going to discuss. Then later we'll talk about it. Okay? Please go on writing that. Another criteria for similarity congruency of the triangle. Please write the congruency of the triangle. Please have writing. If two angles, the theorem next here. two angles and one side of another triangle two side, two angles and one side of another triangle, then such triangles are said to be congruent. I'm repeating this again. If two angles and one side of one triangle equals to two angles and one side of another triangle, then such two triangles are said to be congruent. Is that clear? We need to prove this. How can we prove this? The hint, SAS we have known, well known here. We just have the information earlier. This is to be used further to prove the statement to be true. And ASA also can be used here. Clear? You may see this. So criteria one, theorem number we can speak here. Theorem, it can be 7.3, it can be here. Clear? So what you have been given? You have been given there are two triangles, triangle 1 and triangle 2. Is that clear? It's A, B and C. It's triangle P, Q and R. Is that clear? So what you have been given? Angle A. So you need to write down your first given. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Its angle A is equal to angle P. Angle A is equal to angle P. Second, angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is equal to angle Q. Right now, one pair equal, then one line is to be drawn. Two pair are equal, then two lines to be drawn. Clear? Is that clear? For the side. Angle, angle, side. Angle, angle, side. It's called AS. Is that clear? First we discussed ASA. Second we discussed, sorry, SAS. Then ASA and then AS. Angle, angle, side. Clear? So, what is to prove? To prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. ABC congruent to, which means we will pick up the triangle and place over the other. Then it will completely cover each vertex and each side of the other triangle. Means completely will cover it like that, the fingers, okay? This concept in geometry is called the congruency. Superimposing completely, clear? So, it's simply here. This angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle. So, that day we have performed an activity between you and the other. Yeah? Do you remember this? You think a triangle? Yes, sir, I thought one triangle. You also think a triangle? Yes, you also thought. Tell me please, what of your one angle was that? 30. She told 30. And you told, yes sir, my angle is also 30. She told the another 90. He told also 90. Now what is the third angle of her? You told this here. 90 plus 30 is 60, sir. How can you tell the third angle? Obviously, sir. If the two angles are equal, then third automatically becomes equal. Right now? So what pattern we are observing? This angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle. So this will also equal to this. Why? Similarly, we can write down here. So you may write here, proof. Is that clear? In triangle ABC and triangle PQR. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Since angle A is equal to angle P, can you tell me why this is? The answer given. Now next is angle B is equal to angle R. Tell me this is why. It's again also given. So we need to find out the relation between the third angles. Okay. Therefore, C is equal to, here will be since, therefore C is equal to, no, it's B is equal to Q. Therefore C is equal to R. You need to write an angle. In two triangles, two angles are equal, then third is also equal. Alright. In two triangles, if two angles are equal, then third is also equal. Third is also equal. Clear? So we see this. Therefore, third equal to. So have a big piece. This is the third. It's a third. Clear? So you may see this equals this, this equals this, and this equals this. What pattern we are observing?
SAS.
So you will write here, since BC is equal to QR, BC is equal to QR, therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR.
What pattern we are observing?
ABC
PQR. Is that clear?
Right. Therefore, why we are writing this? By side angle, sides. Both the triangles are congruent.
Remember you. Now the third theorem is just adding to your memory. Angle, angle, side. First you study SAS. Second, ASA. Third, AS. SAS ki ASA ki AS. Is that clear or not? Well, remember you. SAS, ASA, AS. The three criteria for the congruency of triangle. Will remember this or not? In two triangle, if the SAS exists, side angle side, appears this. You have to match the given information, the figure from your information in the brain, your the stored in the your brain. Okay, if it's getting mapped, then you have to yes, SAS is observing here, and ASA just now appears in the figure. Clear? And ASA, AS is also there, angle angle side. So three criteria I told you, SAS, ASA and AS. Two more are there, side, side, side and RHS. Okay, so but due to the limitation all theorem has been have been removed from here, but I will tell you this. Is that clear? Three will you remember and can you observe this? Now come on to this topic. Back to this, converse of isosceles. Converse of 7.2 theorem, isosceles. Converse of isosceles. So you have been given two angles are equal. So what is that here? This angle is equal to this, this angle is equal to this, and this side is common to them. Please go on writing this. In triangle ADB and in triangle ACD. In triangle ADB, clear? In triangle ADB and ADC, ACD also. Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Is that clear? Right now. So ADB, ACD. Clear? Angle ABD. ABD is equal to
angle ABD.
Yeah.
Angle ACD.
ACD. No, it's a triangle. Siri, don't come. Please just get out.
B or D.
ABD. This angle ACD. This is triangle we are talking. In triangle this, in triangle this. Angle ABD, clear, equals angle ACD, clear not? They are equal, tell me please why they are equal, it's a given here. Now next, angle BAD, what is the name of this angle BAD? It is angle 1, it's angle 1 is equal to angle 2, it's angle 2, clear? Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Tell me why they are equal. You will write here AD, yes. AD is the bisector. AD is the bisector. If it's bisector, obviously then this. And AD is equal to AD. Why the AD is equal to it? AD is equal to AD. Tell me is why. It's a common. It's common. Clear? And if this is common, therefore, triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC. The congruency always to correspondence always to be kept in mind. B corresponds C. We are speaking ABD, then we have to speak ACD. ABD, ACD, ADB, ACD. ABD, ADB, ADB, ADC. Clear? If we speak ABD, then we will speak AC and D. Nothing else. It's not yet proved here the congruent there. We proved today with the congruent. After proving congruency, you have to keep remember about the correspondency. Clear or not? So why they are congruent, please? They are congruent by as angle side criteria. Is that clear? Well understood. So today we have seen the congruency criteria as and the isosceles property and converse of isosceles property, how to prove this also. Clear? The next time you will use this as a ready-made result. In any triangle, if you will see the pattern of equality of side or an angle or angles, then you will ready-madely employ them. Is that clear? If the sides are equal, then opposite angles will you take equal. And if the angles equal given, then you will take them the side equal. Clear? Well, understood? Now please proceed. Have you noted them? You see them for 5 seconds. But I have written over to the steps procedures to write. You want to note this question? Please remember this. And fast note, please. Note fast. Done?
That's good.
Now, question, have a look. The exercise. You may see the textbook. Your reference book is the textbook. Yeah? We are discussing here the question. A question, you may also write down the question. In triangle, and this Sunday you have not given the test. Remember, you next Sunday you will give the test. If you don't give the test,
Saturday.
No, on Sunday you will give this test, okay? Not Saturday. If you will not give the test, don't come from next Monday. Is that clear? So, in triangle ABC, the bisector AD of angle A is perpendicular to, you just may write down. What information is given here? Solution number 4 of that. Okay, there is a triangle. Name of the triangle is what? ABC. And question saying here, the bisector of AD of angle A. Bisector of angle A. There is angle A, and its bisector is this. Then this line D is named here. This angle is equal to this. Angle 1 is equal to 2. You have to show the equality of angle by writing their name. Their name, have angle 1, angle 2. Is that clear? What the question is saying? The question is saying, in triangle ABC, AD is the bisector of angle A, and that intersect BC at some point D. There is this. What is to prove here? Prove that ABC is an isosceles. We have to prove ABC is an isosceles. ABC is an isosceles. The questionnaire is given here. AD, however, is a bisector, but it is perpendicular bisector. The word, listen it please again in the question. Perpendicular bisector. Means it's a bisecting it, obviously. But it's what perpendicular also this is. Clear? Listen again, question in triangle ABC. AD of angle A is a perpendicular. Listen again, angle A. AD of angle A is perpendicular to side BC. Perpendicular to, it's a bisector here. This is bisector and it is perpendicular to that. Two things are given. It is bisector, means angle 1 is equal to 2. But this line is also perpendicular to that. Right now? So you are to prove these two, you are to prove ABC is an isosceles. What is the demand for the triangles to be an isosceles? A triangle is to be isosceles.
AB and AC.
Exactly. You can prove the two sides equal, AB and AC. And second, two angle equal, angle B equal angle C. So angle equal B and C can be taken, or AB and AC can be taken as congruency of that. And congruency of the triangle can be brought on the basis of your information. What the informations have been given? This angle is equal to this, AD is bisector, right? And second, this is perpendicular. So this angle is equal to this, tell me why? Each 90. Perpendicular is the 90 degree angle, right angle. This side is what? Common. and this angle is equal to this angle. What pattern you are observing?
Isosceles.
Na pattern, any criteria for congruency? Angle, side, angle. What pattern? Asa. Angle, side, angle. This angle is equal to this. This angle is equal to this. And this side is congruent. So angle, side, angle. Both the triangles are congruent by asa. And if they are congruent, then this side is equal to this side. Why? By simplicity. Is that clear? Let's go on writing the solution. The method. First, you need to write down the given. Right? Given. In triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, AD is the angle bisector. Bisector of A. Okay. That is, means the information is to be explored more. That is, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. And what next to prove? Also, more given here information. What more information is given here? What more information you are given? AD is perpendicular to BC. That is, what we can get from this? Angle this 90 degree. Is that clear or not? So, the information ever you try to show on the figure is information to be picturized. A picture speaks rather than one words. Right now? More than. Clear? So, what is to prove? To prove triangle ABC is an isosceles, that is, what is that? AB is equal to AC or angle B is equal to AC. Any one thing is to be proved. This must run at the background of the solution. Clear? You just not need to write down this statement, but I am just writing this for simplicity, for your easy understanding. Now start writing this. I am not writing proof. You will write the proof. Please go on writing. Please start writing. In triangle ADB and in triangle ADC. In triangle ADB and triangle ADC. ABD and ADB. ABD, ACD. Or ADC, ADC, ADB. Clear? Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. You write down here angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Why? It's given. Clear? Angle D, A, B, B equals A, B, C. Each 90. Argument each 90. Each 90. Each 90. Clear? And AD is equal to AD. AD is equal to AD. Therefore, triangle, go and write in the last line, ADB, congruent, ADC. By argument, the argument you will write, angle, side, angle, by ASA. ASA criteria for the congruency. Noted? Therefore, the last line you will write here, therefore, AC is equal to AB. What AC is equal to ABC? I think you would have written ABD is congruent to ABD is congruent to A, C and D. So the first two vertex will make the side AB. So this here. So AB is equal to AC. This concept is called the correspondency. Correspondency. First vertex of first, second vertex of second. Clear? This is the method of writing the solution. Clear? So you have applied here once the concept of the ASA and the concept of the isosceles property also. Now see the question next. There is another question. This is also an examination point of view question. Clear? You may write them here. Question number 5 we are talking. Solution number 5. You may see that. E and F are the perpendicular. There is a triangle. Clear? Name of the triangle is, it's A, B and it's a C. Clear? ABC triangle, midpoint. E and F are the midpoints of AB and AC. Yes, its midpoint is this E and its midpoint is this F. You just know here, midpoint in this line is equal to this and this is equal to this. Now join this to this. Clear? And this is this to this also. Clear? Like this is. We have to join it. Clear? Go on writing solution, Jeeva. Jeeva. In triangle ABC. In triangle ABC. E and F are the midpoints of AB and AC. What can we conclude from this here? If they are midpoint, it means that is AE is equal to BE and AF is equal to FC. This information, clear? And what more information is given here? Equal sides are there. They are equal side, remember here. AB side is equal to AC side. This is given information, clear? It's also given. If AB side, AC side equal to AB, then the AB opposite to, here first of all this triangle. So the opposite angle is this and its opposite angle is this. Clear now? So you may write down here, this angle is equal to this angle. Clear? The two triangles are here, you may see this, this. One triangle is this being formed here. Clear? And the another triangle being formed here, what? Same, we can understand this. Is the midpoint. The second triangle is this. This angle is also. I'm showing this on the different figures. Clear? This angle is equal to this. So what the first proof is to there? The first proof is to prove that BF is equal to CE. Means this line. It's a B and it's a F and it's line C and it's the E. We have to prove this perpendicular is equal to this. Whatever the perpendicular there, median there actually. This length is equal to this length. Simple. You will take these two triangles. Listen. You will see that. This side we have to prove equal. Are these angles equal to this? One angle are equal. And this BC is common in both. So one angle equal and this common here. The another also can be taken here. BE and CF. You may see that. AB and AC are equal given. AB line and AC line are equal. And E and F are the midpoint. So obviously AE and EB are the half part of these. These are also half part of. If two things are equal, then their halves are also equal. Listen. BE and CF are the half of equal parts. Half of equal sides. Clear? Please go on writing the solution. Explain to that. Proof. In triangle BFC, BFC and triangle CEB, CEB, in triangle BFC and CEB, angle B is equal to angle C. B means what angle? EBC angle, this is called. Angle EBC is equal to angle EBC is equal to BCF. FCB. Tell please why equal. Your reason is ABC is an isosceles. This is an isosceles. Clear? Now next is side BC is equal to BC. Tell please why. It's a common. Clear? Now next is side CF is equal to CF is equal to BE. Why there? So you will write here
half of equals, halves of equal, halves of equal, halves of equals are also equal. Therefore, what pattern we are observing? The pattern side angle side, side angle side, both the triangles are congruent. Therefore, triangle PEC, BEC is congruent to triangle CBEC, CFB, CFB. CFB. If they are correspond, then what this? It is called BF. So it's a BF is what? No. CE and BF. Where is CE? There is some mistake. Yeah, EC. It is EC. E of C is equal to FB. Hence they are equal. By what? By CPCD. This is by CPCD. Well, understood? Please have note down and see the observation. Observe it. How can we solve this? Take a 5-minute look for the solution. Okay, the 5-minute look will help you to understand the steps and how. Actually, I have to think how to, I just took the decision. How I apply the method of solving question. The same thing you have to think. Noted this? Now see, your assignment of the day today is C of the exercise. The question number 7.2 exercise. First 4 questions you will need to try to solve them. Okay? Slowly, one by one, you will solve. The procedure same here. After reading the question, you draw the figure, write down the given, and why and what the given are here. What is to prove here? And given are to be related with the proof, to prove. Clear? And just ready-made pattern also you need to observe on the figure. Clear? Thank you very much. And I'm staying. 1 to 4 is your assignment.